Hi again. This is the second part of a game to escape reality or the ninth part of a game to get them back series. I'm thinking of doing a Q&A at some point, since I might not be able to post one of these longer videos at some point. If you have any questions about me or my stories, please comment them down below. Also, I do not own the Haikyuu characters and this does not accurately represent the Haikyuu characters. Hope you enjoy the video. The group stayed and watched the TV to see if something caught their eyes. Oh. Komori found a pen and paper as he started writing down something on it. What? Shut up. Osamu frowned as Komori continued writing. Hey. You hear that? Hinata looked towards the room where Kiru and Daisha were. Is that Tsumu's voice? I think so. Finished. Komori held up the paper as it showed a bunch of ones and zeros on it. Is that binary?
Yeah.
What are they talking about? Osamu got up with the rest of the group as they approached the door that Kiru and Daisha shut. They listened for a minute more, and heard them explaining something. Then, finally, they heard Atsumu. Seriously? Seriously. They all burst into the room. Kiru. Daisha.
Hello?
Komori waved to Kiru and Daisha. I heard Tsumu's voice.
Samu?
Oh. That's cheating.
Kiru turned around and glared at the group as they all hesitantly walked out of the room. Scary. I guess they are just starting their game.
Guess so.
Back to the binary. Anyone know how to decode it? Doesn't that say something like hero? Hinata looked at the sheet of paper reading the numbers. You cannot read binary.
Sure I can.
Not possible. You're too dumb. Kageyama and I tried it out for some volleyball gestures. It took too long to complete a word though. The whole group stared wide-eyed at Hinata.
What?
You memorized binary for volleyball? It wasn't that hard. They all continued staring, too shocked to say anything.
Let's see.
Yeah. The first one is hero. The second one is love. The third is family. And the fourth is six.
Dot.
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 Correct. You figured out the binary.
Woo.
Now figure out what your word is. The first story was mine, obviously. It had twins, so I have hero. I think my story was the third one? They got distant with each other, so I assume mine is family. Unfortunately, my story was the lemon story. So mine is six. Meaning I had the dice story, meaning my word is love.
Correct again.
You guys are on a roll. Now about the morals.
About that.
Keep them to yourselves. Just think about it. For now, go to your rooms. Each room was assigned to you by the straw you drew earlier. Longest straw gets the upstairs room to the right.
That's me.
Oikawa walked upstairs and towards his room. Shortest straw gets the room down here to the right.
Okay?
Have fun. Osamu walked behind Kiru and Daisha and towards the room. Second longest gets the room down here to the left.
Yay.
That kind of energy is strange. Especially in this situation. Hinata walked behind the two as he approached his door. Komori, you get the upstairs room to the left.
Okay, thanks.
Komori walked away as Kiru and Daisha stood in the living room. The others almost found out.
Yep.
If they find out the game is ruined, idiot.
Let them try to figure it out.
Dot. They have Atsumu and Kageyama on their team.
Fair enough.
Daisha rolled his eyes as Tsukishima approached the two. You know this is stupid, right?
Fick.
Where did you come from?
My room.
This isn't stupid.
It's fun.
You're only going to make everything worse.
It won't work.
Says the one who was worried.
I was worried, sure.
Did I want this?
No.
It's fine.
Everything will be okay.
Are you telling me or yourselves that?
Dot.
Dot. Oikawa walked up to his door and looked down at the lock. It only needed three letters to unlock. Guess it really was six. Oikawa unlocked the door as he walked into the room. The room was big, with a king-sized bed in the middle of it and a bathroom attached to it.
Master bedroom. Nice.
Oikawa nodded in approval as he walked fully into the room. As he did, the door behind him shut quickly and loudly.
Exclamation mark.
Oikawa walked up to it and tried to open it again, which didn't happen since it was locked again.
All right.
Oikawa turned towards where the voice was coming from, and saw a TV with Daisha on it.
Oikawa, welcome to your personal escape room.
Oh. This is Liv.
Oh.
Anyways, the rules are simple.
Escape.
How?
Find clues and escape the room.
Pretty simple.
Sure.
Good luck.
Ask for a hint if you need it.
All right.
Bye.
Oikawa walked over to the screen and turned it off. Oikawa looked around the room for anything that caught his eye, but nothing stood out.
I was not made for this. Oikawa continued searching, looking at the calendar with a giant red heart on one day, finding a paper with some letter on it, and a weird message on the mirror. His birthday to salad shift.
Okay then.
So what? His birthday? And what is a salad shift?
Hello?
I can't believe this. Oikawa turned towards the TV once again, but this time he saw Matsun and Maki.
Hi.
What's up?
This is so weird.
Whatever.
What are you two doing?
Dot.
I forgot.
Same.
They both looked down at their phones, and read something.
Right.
Okay.
Oikawa.
Yeah?
We've been friends for a while, right?
I guess.
Oikawa rolled his eyes.
Want to date?
Hey.
What the fick?
Maki, you have a boyfriend.
Hypothetical then.
If you didn't have Iwaizumi and I didn't have Matsun, would you want to date?
No.
Why?
Because, I don't see you that way.
Alright.
Hey,
Oikawa?
What now?
Why is there a difference between boyfriend and friend?
I wish I knew.
There has to be a difference, though. Other than just physical attention.
Ah. There is a difference?
Shut your stupid mouth. Maki smiled evilly at Matsun as Matsun shut up.
Alright Oikawa, we're going to head out.
But think about what we asked, and why we asked you.
It's important.
Matsun nodded as the screen went dark.
How would I know?
Oikawa shook his head as he looked back down at his collected items, calendar, mirror message, and piece of paper. Oikawa picked up the piece of paper and raised an eyebrow.
UNSC to kids?
What? Oikawa shrugged and decided to think about what he was given. He flopped onto the bed and looked at the ceiling as he noticed a piece of paper taped there. He got up and pulled it down as he saw it read. A bunch of scrambled letter that I am too lazy to type out.
Answer it.
I can't read gibberish. Oikawa crumpled up the piece of paper and threw it against the wall. At the same time, after Osamu unlocked the door, he walked into his room and sighed. The door behind him shut like Oikawa's, but Osamu knew it was locked. It was the laundry room. It was cramped with only a little walkway between the washing machine and dryer. There was a door at the end of the room, which was actually a bathroom.
What the hell?
Damn, straws. Osamu scoffed as he heard the sound of a screen turning on. He turned around to see a small TV.
Welcome to your own personal escape room, Osamu.
Wavader. This is Liv, we can hear you.
So?
Osamu rolled his eyes.
Okay then.
Anyways, there is only one rule.
Escape.
Alright.
Let me guess.
Find clues.
Figure out puzzles.
And then some way, somehow, I'll escape.
Maybe.
Kyuru frowned as he started to pout.
You're no fun.
You put me in a laundry room.
Fair enough.
Anyways, ask for a hint when you need one.
If.
When.
The screen shut off as Osamu looked around the cramped space.
It was surprisingly clean. He soon found Atsumu's journal, a piece of paper, and a message in the mirror. His birthday to Gaius shift.
Gaius?
Who?
Probably Gaius Julius Caesar.
Osamu jumped as he turned around to see Kida on the screen.
Give me a heart attack, why don't ya?
That isn't medically correct.
Oh, hey Kida.
Hello Samu.
Why are you on a TV screen?
Technically you are for me, so I can't answer that.
Makes sense.
Why are you here Kida?
Just a few questions for you.
Go ahead and ask, then.
Why do you bottle up your emotions?
I don't.
Does Atsumu even know you?
I mean, you're faking so much for him.
How well do you two actually know each other?
I
don't get the question.
Osamu looked at Kida pleadingly, and Kida knew Osamu wanted him to answer the question.
Samu.
I'm sorry, but this is your problem.
I'm told I'm supposed to say, think about why I asked you these questions.
The screen turned off as Osamu looked around aimlessly. He had been caught off guard and didn't know what to do.
Osamu's
eyes finally landed upon some weirdly lined up shirts that said, MTWWTW to horror.
I don't want to, but I have to give Daisha and Kyuru props for setting all this up. I think they messed up a word though.
Osamu chuckled to himself as he looked down at the items he gathered. He looked at the piece of paper closely.
Jumble of letters.
Answer it.
More than one word I guess.
Osamu shook his head as he leaned against the dryer and sighed again. At the same time, Hinata put in the code to the lock, and after many tries he finally got the lock to open.
Geez, why use such a complicated lock?
Hinata walked into the room as the door shut behind him, but he didn't seem to notice. He was more surprised to see a bedroom full of junk.
Is this the guest bedroom?
Hinata walked closer to the bed as he noticed the TV in front of it turn on, revealing Daishao.
Sup, Shrimpy.
Hi. Welcome to your escape room.
Cool.
Do you know what to do?
Escape.
And how to do it.
Clues, puzzles, and stuff.
Good. Now go ahead and escape.
Woo.
Hinata jumped up as he started looking around the room.
He, like the others, found a piece of paper and a mirror message.
Unlike the others, he found a volleyball and two meat buns.
The mirror message said his birthday to Tyrant Shift.
What is a tyrant?
He immediately started eating the meat buns.
He sat on the foot of the bed, looking at the TV, as it surprisingly turned on.
Is it on?
Daichi was looking off camera as he nodded, as if he was told something.
Hinata.
Daichi. Hinata tried saying his name with his mouth full.
Finish chewing first.
Hinata nodded as he chewed his food, and was shocked when he bit down on something papery. He spit it out as he finished chewing.
Hi Daichi.
Hi. You seem to be having fun.
Of course. Kyuru and Daisha made an escape room.
True. Daichi shrugged as he lifted up his phone, reading something on it.
Alright, I have some questions for you.
Uh-oh. This isn't a test.
Okay.
Then ask away.
Why is love so important to you?
Isn't it important to everyone?
The word love.
Oh. I don't know.
Is the word love necessary to know if someone loves you?
Of course.
Of course?
Yeah.
How else are you supposed to know?
Hinata had almost finished his second meat bun as he felt another papery thing and spit it out.
Oh Hinata, stop spitting out your food.
I can't eat paper.
Question mark.
Alright then.
Anyways.
Hinata. Think about these questions a little more and try to figure out why your answers were
odd.
Were they?
Yeah.
Hinata looked at Daichi confused as the screen turned off, leaving Hayanta looking at the paper that was in his meat buns. The first one said YKIZU. The second one said comedy.
Wow. It's gibberish.
Hinata looked closer at the text, trying to figure out if it was a puzzle or not. He then focused his attention on the piece of paper he had found, which also had gibberish on it.
Gibberish.
Answer it.
Maybe they correlate?
Hinata took the papers and continued to stare at it trying to figure it out. At the same time, Komori unlocked his door first try, and walked inside, closing the door himself.
An escape room?
Komori wandered around the room, which he determined to be the office in the house. It was surprisingly attached to a bathroom. He noticed a computer and monitor that were on, and when he got closer to it, the screen turned on.
Exclamation mark.
Sorry. I wasn't expecting you to be looking over here.
Kyuru appeared on the screen.
Oh.
Hey Kyuru.
Hi.
What's up?
Just came here to make sure you know what's happening.
Yeah.
It's an escape room.
Cool.
Good luck then.
Thanks.
The screen turned off as Komori continued looking around. While searching for things he found a piece of paper on the printer, a mask with writing on it, a message in the mirror, and a funnel cake.
Yum.
Komori started eating as he looked at the thing he had found. The mirror message said his birthday to Roman General Shift. The mask had the writing, more letter that aren't words, and answer it on it.
Aggressive wording I see.
He finally looked at the printer paper and saw the words NBKWK to drama on it.
Clever puzzles. Daisha and Kyuru.
This is so cool. Komori jumped once again as he turned to face the monitor, which now had Nishinoya's face on it.
Hey Komori.
Hey Noya.
What are you doing?
Helping Kyuru and Daisha with some stuff.
Alright then.
So, I guess I have to ask you a few questions.
Cool.
So, we're friends, right?
I think so.
And we talk a lot?
Yeah?
What do we talk about?
Usually volleyball, sometimes love.
And?
That's about it.
Would you say we're close?
Yeah.
I mean, we talk a lot.
Alright.
Nishinoya nodded as the screen went black. Some text appeared on the screen as Komori was about to turn away.
Why would we ask you such questions?
Komori shrugged and turned away as he focused his attention back on the words.
Hope you enjoyed the video.
Remember, you have to figure out the coded messages, but you don't have to answer them unless you want to.
Also, figure out why the questions were given.
The next video will be the next part of Atsumu is Evil.
Exciting news.
I have a Discord server, you can join with the link in the description below.
Also, I have an Instagram if you'd like to follow, there is a link in the description below.
I usually just post random pictures I draw or pictures from my videos.
If you'd like to support me, and maybe buy me a coffee to keep me awake for my late night editing sessions,
There is a link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching and thank you for your support.